to inform all members of this House of the necessary action taken today to remove all responsibilities and authority of the South Shore Regional School Board and transfer it to a new appointed representative. As I am sure all members are aware, the South Shore Regional School Board made a request to the province to conduct a performance review for the board. This request came after concerns were raised about the openness and decision-making ability of the board. The province granted the board's request, and Deloitte was contracted to evaluate how they function and operate as a board. Mr. Speaker, Deloitte submitted their final report to me on Tuesday, November the 22nd, and today that report was made public and I am tabling it in the House. The findings in this report were troubling and disappointing. Among other things, the report found strong evidence of not only failure to withdraw from matters under discussion, but also of active involvement in areas of pecuniary interest as defined by the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. The board made excessive and inappropriate use of in-camera sessions. It spent 31% of its meeting time in-camera, reducing time for public sessions and causing it to failed to meet its obligation for public accountability. Some board members reported that they did not feel they could speak freely without personal consequences. Staff members reported a considerable lack of trust between a number of board staff and members. That, with regard to the school review process, personal agendas of some of the board members appear to have trumped their responsibilities to the board and region as a whole. The conclusion stated, "We believe that the capabilities required to successfully implement the recommendations are largely absent from the board, and success is unlikely to be achieved by the current members, even with substantial outside assistance. Mr. Speaker, it is clear from the report that this board is unable to function in the best interest of students and teachers. As Minister of Education, I could not allow this situation to continue. And today I met with the school board members and made them aware of my decision. This action, though necessary, is regrettable. It was not targeted at any individual, nor was it something I wanted to do. However, nothing is more important to me than the educational welfare of students, teachers, and families. Mr. Speaker, this is the right thing to do for students." The report also found that the staff and administration of the South Shore Regional School Board has continued to act professionally, and I thank them for their good work. Mr. Speaker, today I appointed Judith Sullivan Corney to assume the full responsibilities and authorities of the school board. Ms. Sullivan Corney is a former Deputy Minister of the Public Service Commission and Aboriginal Affairs, has experience in governance, policy making, human resources, and has even spent some of her career in the classroom. Ms. Sullivan Corney will assume these responsibilities until school board elections take place in October 2012. I am confident she will provide the necessary stability and leadership to ensure the educational welfare of students and teachers is looked after. Mr. Speaker, our regional school boards play an important role in the delivery of education to our students. They provide local input into decisions that impact their communities. I thank the members of the South Shore Regional School Board for their interest in public service and for the time they committed to serving their community. And I have no doubt that individually each board member brought certain strengths to the board. I know they all care deeply about students and the communities they serve, and I'm sure they all started out with the best of intentions, but as a group, as the Deloitte report shows, they are not functioning effectively or in the best interest of our students. Mr. Speaker, today is a new day for the students, teachers, and families of the South Shore. The work ahead will be challenging, but equal to that challenge is the positive impact our education system has on the future of our province. Mr. Speaker, this process identified a gap in the Education Act. The board requested this review, and under legislation today, the minister has limited power to request a performance review of a school board. It is my intention to bring forward amendments to the Act that will clarify the minister's ability to conduct performance reviews, keeping school boards accountable to all Nova Scotians. And Mr. Speaker, this government remains committed to putting children and learning first. And with that, Mr. Speaker, I would, may I have permission to make an introduction?
Most certainly, but you're going to table that report also.
Yes, I will.
Thank
I will
you.
Do that. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it is my pleasure to introduce Judith Sullivan Corney, who is joining us in the East Gallery. Ms. Sullivan Corney has served the province for many years, including roles as Deputy Minister and Chief Executive Officer of Aboriginal Affairs and Public Service Commissioner. Ms. Sullivan Corney is a parent who has her BED, but it is her most and is her interest in students and education that will be our most valuable asset as she steps into another important leadership role with the South Shore Regional School Board. I would like to welcome her here today and thank her for taking on this important work for teachers, parents, and students in the South Shore Regional School Board. And I hope that she receives a warm welcome of my colleagues here today. Thank you.
To the gallery and hope that they enjoy today's proceedings. I will now recognize the Honourable Member for Colchester North. Yay!